Hare Krishna. From your place, at your pace, access the grace. The Bhagavad Gita offers us a vision of a God and His mercy that is very accommodating and extending. God offers His grace, but He is so kind that He is ready for us to take the grace in whatever way we can, from our place. It's like sometimes some person might give charity. And then they say, you come to my house, which may sometimes be hundreds of miles away, then I'll give you charity. But Krishna is such a person who says, I will come to your place. Wherever you are, I'll come and give you charity over there. And sometimes some people may want to give charity, but they say, okay, I'll give you $1,000 right now. But somebody may say, okay, actually, I don't need $1,000 right now. I can only take this much money. And I need some more money afterwards. Then Krishna says, okay, if you want it later, you take what you want now, I'll give remaining to you later. From our place, at our pace, Krishna is inviting us to accept His grace. Let's see how this is manifest towards the end of the Bhagavad Gita. Krishna speaks the whole Bhagavad Gita, which is a message of divine love. He bares His heart, revealing how much He loves every one of us. And then He invites us to love Him back. And in that invitation to love Him back, He offers us a descending ladder of love. He first says that those who share this message of the Bhagavad Gita with others, they are extremely dear to me. In 18.68 and 69, He says, Yaidam paramam guhyam mad bhakteshu abhidasyati bhaktim mai param krutva mame vaishatya samshaya. Those who share this knowledge, they are most dear to me. Next verse, He says, there is no one as dear to me as them. Then after that, He says, somebody may say that actually, you know, studying and teaching this message to everyone else, that's very difficult. I can't do it. And Krishna says, okay, if you can't teach it, just study it. Adishyate chaya imam dharmyam samvadam avayo jnana yagyena tenaham ishtasyam iti mehmati. He says, by the that those who study this knowledge, the sacred conversation of ours, they are worshipping me with their intelligence, Krishna says. So He appreciates even those who are studying Him, studying this knowledge. And then He says, in 18.71, somebody may say that, oh, studying also is very difficult. And Krishna says, just hear it. Shraddhavan anasuyascha shrunuyadapi yo naraha sopi muktah shubha lokan prapnuyat punya karmanam. Even if one hears this message, Krishna says, they will also become elevated. They will also become liberated. Such is the accommodating nature of Krishna. So a similar descending ladder of love, of grace, is seen in the 12th chapter also, from 12.8 to 12.12. Essentially, Krishna is so eager that we unite with Him, that we attain Him, that He extends Himself more and more. Please come to Me. From whatever level you are at, in whatever way you can, just come to Me. Understanding how eager Krishna is to give His grace to us can soften and open our hearts and thereby inspire us to reciprocate with Him, to embrace His grace and thereby become elevated and liberated. Thank you. Hare Krishna.